हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस. माई सेल्फ सुनील कुमार. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट टेम्पलेट इन सी प्लस प्लस. सो टेम्पलेट इज ए मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट कंसेप्ट इन सी प्लस प्लस, और वी कैन से इट इज़ ए पावरफुल टूल. टेम्पलेट मीन्स टू डिज़ाइन ए क्लास विच कैन एक्सेप्ट डाटा टाइप्स एज ए पैरामीटर. So we don't need to waste time to write the same code again and again, because our class is able to accept all types of data in one class template. Instead of design different version of same class or writing code again and again, we are just making a one module of class. So two types of keyword are used in C++. First is template. Second is type name, or we can use class in replacement of this. So in old time or in earlier, we are using class name. So this is the example of simple class, as we have already done in our class sum int ab public. There is a constructor with name and it containing two parameters, and a is equal to x, b is equal to y, and then there is a function add where we are initializing a variable, declaring variable c equal to a plus b, and then print the result. So we can remove this int, we can use here void, and then void main function that is calling with two objects, that is containing s 4 5. So that is acceptable here. Then if you are passing float value in this class, it is not acceptable by this constructor. We need to declare one more constructor with float type of variables. Okay, then we are switching from simple class to template class. So template class T, this template keyword is used. Here we can use class or type name. T is just is a holder that will used for holding the integer, float or character type of value, what type of data types we are passing from main function. So class sum here TAB. So T is a type of AB, like if T is a int, then it will be converted into int, then A comma B. So A and B are integer type. In similar way, public section, there is a function equivalent to this our previous class, and this TX, TY, and then we are initializing the class variable, then use void add TC, C type is C, and the type of C is T, C is equal to A plus B, then print this. In void main method, we are declaring a object with type of parameters, sum, angular bracket, then you can write here T. T means this is a type. Here you will write integer. So this int will be copied into T, or T will be replaced by integer. Then whole class is replaced T with integer. In similar way, next T you can write here float, and then s 4.5 5.6. so this is the example of template class. So here we can say that class with template means class with parameter. And then the next slide contain concept of templates. The templates are often used in large size of code for the purpose of code reusability and extendability. We can say it is a flexible to write the program. The concept of templates can be used in two different ways. First is function template, second is class template. So the working of template expanded at compile time means when we are compiling the template class, every function which can be assigned a different memory according to the data types sent by main function object. So if you are assigning integer and float, you created two objects, then two memories are allocated for one function in template class. So it's a expanded means the expansion of template. this is just like as a macro programming. In macro, when we are calling a macro functions, that code is replaced at the calling cold place from where we are calling it. So compiler will check for type checking at compile time. Yes, here compiler will also check for what type of value you are passing as a parameter or what type of data types we are passing. So based on that, we can say compiler will check type safety is there, but in macro there is no type safety, there is no checking of data type. And then in this source code only this in the source code a generic form of class is contained. After compilation, code may be multiple copies of same function because it is depending on what type of data types we are passing from main method for calling the class functions. Ultimately, it is based on type of parameter. Okay, so next slide. Class template, compiler generate new code with specific type. So it means according to data type, it becomes specific function that is assigned some unique memory for that particular function. So there is a specific type. Template type name T, or we can use here class T. Each data type make their own function space at compile time. As we already discussed, there is separate memory and source code is same, but object code have different memory. Source code is a single copy of class with templates, but after compilation there is a different types of memory for each functions. Function template, we write a generic function that can be used for different data types. Function template can be of any type, but like just for example sort, max, mean and print array, these are the functions we can make them template, like sorting of integer variables, integer array, sorting of float, sorting of char arrays, just we can use it. After compilation it behave like a function overloading, but minor differences in its structure, because function overloading we have a definition like that the type of argument, the number of argument and order of argument is considered in function overloading. There is no type checking for signature, means there is no checking for written type. But here after compilation the complete function signature is checked with argument and written type. Function template, there is an example of function max function. So template type name T, return x greater than y, question mark x this. So this is a ternary condition. Here we can also analyze that there is a code angle bracket and angular bracket is there. So this is a greater sign and this is used for mentioning the type. So we can see that there is a operator overloading. And int main, here max int, we are passing int to t and 3, 7. So these values are copied into x and y, then it will check for larger value or maximum value, then it will return as to the one value that will be printed here. Max double and max char, here character will be sent though, so it will behave like as a character value. So the type is changing according our object or function calling. So the next, template overloading, template function overloaded. We can overload template function plus normal functions. Both functions can be defined in a class and it is considered as a function overloading. Our normal function is have high priority. First the data type is checked for normal function. If it is not matching, then it will call the template function as just as we are using like a max function. Here integer, double and float. For float data type, if you have created one more max function with specific type like float, then it will call float only. And if it is not matching with float, then it will go for template type of function. Add This is the example of normal function and template. So class templates are useful when a class defines something that is independent on data type, because it is not something that is independent of data type. Class templates are useful. Independent of the data types. So data types are not defined for the class blueprint. When you are designing class, it is independent of particular data type. So we can use number of data types from the main function and can be useful for class like linked list, binary tree, stack, queue and array. If we are designing a specific class for specific data structure and this class is a generic type, because using this we can hold any integer value, we can hold float value, we can hold character value. So our linked list or any data structures become a generic. So this type of construction of any class or designing of class is called generic class. Class can be overloaded with specialization. Sometimes class can overloaded with template data type and with some specific data type. So overloading with specialization means we are passing just only one data type using class template. So here is the example of type name T, array, private pointer, and then size of pointer or array. So array is a constructor with array and s. Void print is a function. Both these constructor and functions are defined outside the class. Then template type T. If you are defining anything outside class, then you have to mention the template type, because there is no mentioning of any template. And array is a return type. T is a variable. What type of variable it will return? So according to this, the type is changing. Like if there is integer, then it will be converted into integer. Array is a constructor name. Here we are just mentioning the name of class, because constructor doesn't have any return type as we know, but constructor is a part of class. So the name of class and T, and T array int s, p is equal to new, it is for memory location. T is according to the type, it will be changed. What type of data we are using, like in example, if we considered here array, for example array A equal to, we are using new keyword for memory allocation and then class name like array. Yes, so according to this, here we are using P. P is a T type. So P T P equal to new T. So there is a name of class. Here name of class is int P and new T S. So size S for int I equal to 0, I less than size, I plus plus for memory initialization. Then template type name T, void array T, print function. And using loop we can print it, p plus I for changing the memory location and pointer of that memory location to printing the value. So int main functions, there is an integer array and array int a array and 5, it is passing to the constructor. So constructor will be initialized according to this. Then you can use a dot print. So print is a template type function, return 0 and then it is final. So this is the example of template class where we are using array, pointer type of array. More than two arguments, we can also use two or three arguments for the template classes. Class T, class U, it is used for different types of data types. We can pass different type of data type like char, int, double. So there is a different type of data types. According to this, you can use T and U, but it has to be remember what type of data types you are passing for this. According to that, you have to make your operations where you are defining any calculating function. Template advanced feature, function overloading and templates. Function overloading can be done within a templates. or in our normal class. In normal class we know the definition of function overloading, but in if you are using template functions and without template function in a template class, then it is considered as a template function overloading, and this term is a simple function overloading. So difference means there is a totally, it is used for performing the identical operation. In function overloading, it is just for checking the same type of function name and their parameters, but not the return types, not the body part of the function. Static member in a template, if we are creating a static member in a template, that member function is assigned a global memory, and the variable data types of that static member function is globally available according to the type sent by main function. Non-type parameter to template. Non-type parameter means if we are using int max, so there is no type according to class T. Here it is considered as a typed parameter. So non-type means that is defined by the, sent by the or declared by the user. So int array means is a function. Here T array is used for this, and int n is a simple data type, fundamental data type, non-typed. And here we can mention also for calling this function int handled array n1. Array type is integer and handled is n1 for this, that is max. Class template specialization. Sometimes if you are declaring a template empty angle braces, there is no definition of data type for type name, then class my template, and this class is containing this char type of variable, means after declaring this, in next line we will write class my template char. So this class is a specific type, it can only handle char type of data. Specialized template. A class template provide a specifications for generating class based on parameter. Class templates are generally used to implement containers. Using these number of functions which are template type, then we can go for the template generally used to implement the class into container, implement the containers, means where we are designing everything related to a specific concept of data structure and all are generalized, then it becomes a container. Write code once and use it for any data type including this. So one time we are writing code and we can pass any data type. So there is something missing. Specialized template is giving example like simple class, simple template class, class T, font this. And in specialized class, we are writing here template with empty data types, void fun int A. So here int A is already specified. So this function is called specialized template function. In similar way, if we are declaring class like template class T, class std, then it is a template class, and after writing this, if you are writing class std, both class can have same name, but here std, then in angular bracket if you are passing int, then it is a specialized class and it is a templatized class like this. This is a example of templatized class, class test int and template this. So this is a specialized class and this is a templatized class and this is specialized class. So we will move next. Thank you so much. If you have any query, please you can ask through email. Email is already mentioned on this slide. So thank you so much.